In this video, we demonstrate the operation principle, fabrication steps, and experimental characterization of a silicon Mach-Zehnder electro-optical modulator. This work was done at the Hebrew University of Jerusalem within the framework of the TERASANTA consortium. One of the critical elements for on-chip silicon photonic application is a silicon electro-optic modulator. Due to the weak electro-optic effect, optical signal modulation in silicon is often achieved via the free carrier plasma dispersion effect, where the changes in the free carrier concentration induce variations in both real and imaginary parts of the complex refractive index. Nowadays, common construction of silicon electro-optical modulators relies on the embedding of electrical diode operating under forward or reverse bias conditions into photonic structures such as microring resonators or Mach-Zehnder interferometers. Typically, the operation in depletion mode provides higher modulation speed and lower power consumption as compared to injection-type devices. Traditional challenges in optimization of silicon electro-optical modulators are related to the weak nature of the plasma dispersion effect and the inevitable optical losses induced by the free carrier absorption. In the conventional approach of using vertical or horizontal p-n junction configurations, the efficiency of electro-optical modulation is highly dependent on the junction position within the wavelength. In this video, we present simulation, fabrication process, and experimental characterization of silicon Mach-Zehnder electro-optical modulator, where the phase shifter is realized by embedding a periodic lattice of p-n along the submicron silicon wavelength. By optimization of the device's parameters such as periodicity and doping level, it was possible to operate in a nearly full depleted mode, and by doing so maximize the modulation effect, minimize the free carrier loss. Our device is fabricated using silicon on an insulator substrate with 250 nanometers thick silicon device layer. First, the photonic structure consisting of an asymmetric Mach-Zehnder interferometer was defined by E-beam lithography followed by partial deep reactive ion etching of silicon. Next, the interleaved p-n junctions were created in both arms of the device by boron and phosphorus ion implementation. After that, the device was covered by silicon dioxide, followed by opening VIS trenches for the contacts. Finally, RF-matched ohmic contacts were formed by deposition and alloying aluminium electrodes on top of highly doped silicon areas. Device characterization includes different steps. First, we perform DC characterization of the optical and electrical properties of the device. The optical input of the device was connected to the laser, and the optical output of the device was connected to the optical detector using tapered fibers and butt coupling configuration. The electrodes of the phase shifter were connected to the voltage source. In this configuration, we measure the current voltage characteristic and the optical transmission of the device under different applied voltages. Next, the dynamic performance of the device was characterized. For this purpose, the electrical input of the device was connected to the electrical wave generator, and the optical output was inspected by a fast real-time oscilloscope. To find the roll-off frequency of the device, we used a vector network analyzer. First, we mount the sample on a vacuum holder. Next, we move the lens fiber and electrical signal ground signal probe towards the sample. We perform the final alignment of the fibers and electrical probe under a microscope, where the submicron alignment of the optical lens fibers is obtained by maximizing the optical power at the output of the device. Next, we characterize the DC performance of the modulator by taking its transmission spectrum under different applied voltages. From these measurements, we can clearly observe the shift in transmission spectrum. From this shift, we can calculate the VπL to be 0.75 volt-centimeter. Also, we performed free carrier loss measurements by applying voltage to both arms of the interferometer. By doing so, there is no shift in the spectrum and we can track the loss as function of the applied voltage. By combining the spectral shift with the loss measurements, we found the figure of merit of our device, defined as VπL multiplied by the loss per unit length, to be as low as 5 volt dB, which is about 3 times better than previously demonstrated devices. Our next goal is to characterize the dynamic behavior of our device. To do so, the optical output of the device was connected to an erbium-doped fiber amplifier followed by an optical tunable filter. The output optical power of the setup was maximized by tuning a tunable optical filter. Next, the modulated electrical signal together with the constant DC bias were applied to the phase shifter. The yellow trace shown on the oscilloscope is the drive signal and the purple line is the optical signal at the output of the device. After this coarse alignment of the extinction ratio of the output signal is maximized by fine-tuning of the operation wavelength, bias voltage and wavelength of a tunable filter. As can be seen, the frequency of the output optical signal follows very nicely the frequency of the electrical input signal. For completeness, we also perform frequency measurement. Specifically, we measure the 3 dB roll-off frequency of the device by connecting its electrical input and optical output to a vector network analyzer. Based on these measurements, our modulator demonstrates a 3 dB optical bandwidth of about 0.5 GHz. In our device, this value is limited by the contact resistance. However, this high contact resistance could be significantly reduced by available technological solutions, and it does not represent a fundamental barrier for attaining high modulation efficiency. To conclude, we have demonstrated a chip-scale miniaturized silicon photonic modulator with a record figure of merit of 5 volt dB and a very good VπL of 0.75 volt centimeter. The device can be further improved to demonstrate high operation bandwidth.